Here's the latest stories making the headline amongst the Filipino community. We begin with over 200 people gathering at the South San Francisco Convention Center to celebrate the election victory of Philippine President-elect Bongbong Marcos and Vice President-elect Sara Duterte. Many of these Philam say they contributed to the victory by registering voters for the May 9th polls. For them, the election win also didn't come as a surprise.
People really, you know, wanted to have a change, and they really wanted President Marcos or Bongbong Marcos to lead our country. Like I've said, you know, they trust him, you know, and that is really obvious, and you cannot question that.
While these Philams are celebrating,
never again to martial law, never again.
They are also aware of multiple demonstrations that were carried out at Philippine consulates across the U.S. to protest Marcos's victory. Marcos supporter Chito Desposito says it is ultimately up to the president-elect's main rival, Vice President Lenny Robredo, to concede.
She should make a clear concession and make sure that the followers follow that. Because not only is it noble, but it is civil to accept the defeat so that we can move forward and work towards unity and solving the problems in the country.
Let's go to Jersey City, New Jersey, where you can find the longest-running Santa Cruz Sun and Flores de Mayo celebration in the East Coast, dating back to 1978.
May is the month of Mary, so if you look at the title, it's called Santa Cruz Sun and Flores de Mayo, which is flowers of May. So every day in the month of May, the Filipinos give flowers to our Blessed Mother. So to crown it all, this is like the epic of that end of that month of May. A crown with the Santa Cruzan, which is the Holy Cross celebration.
Hundreds of Filipinos lined up the streets as the parade made its way to a fiesta celebration at Manila Avenue. Leading the parade was a Hermano Mayor, who carried a reliquary of the True Cross. They say it's a piece of wood from the actual cross of Christ.
It's amazing that we're finally back, and that means the celebration that we have has more depth, and that means we can really truly feel the sentiments of celebrations like this.
And finally, in entertainment news, he was one of the biggest singers during the pandemic, doing virtual shows from his living room. And now, Philippine concert king Martin Navera is back on the road for shows in the Philippines and the U.S. On June 12th, Martin is headlining Haming ng Kalayaan in Washington, D.C., TSC's biggest show yet since the pandemic stopped live events.
Now more than ever, we need this to show unity and to be part of that, to be the soundtrack of that, to sing for an event like that. You know, TFC has always been known to bring people together.
And those were the latest headlines from North America. You can catch our stories online at news.abs-cbn.com/TFC News and the ABS-CBN News YouTube channel.